Good morning, my flabbergasted French flamingo. I started reading this book this morning, as I also started wearing some like glasses that have a light that shines down to get your circadian rhythm in point. An invitation to true freedom and lasting happiness. So I want to just pick on one thing really quickly. And it's essentially like, very loosely, I would say I'm a stoic, which means the things that I can control, I will control. But anything that I can't have control over, I don't worry about it. I'm not talking about being a control freak. I'm talking about if I can, let's say I want to make a video. Okay, oh, cool, I'll go and make a video. But can I directly affect the number of views that video gets? No. So I shouldn't really worry about that stuff. I should just worry about making the video that I think is the best, right? And then learn from it and loop back in. But this book, I just started chapter 2 and I thought it would be good to read through these things here. And just kind of see the feeling that comes out of them. I would like to share my experience of reading this book with you. So like each morning I'll read a chapter and then share my thoughts on it. Okay. But I say that as I have read chapter 1 and not read chapter 2, but I'm going into chapter 2. So these are some things, some affirmations that it suggests you say to yourself each morning. Honestly, it makes me cringe already, but I am pure. I am innocent. I am already worthy. I forgive myself and others. I am wanted and needed. I am seen. I am free from my past. I have no regrets. I face my fears with courage. I expect the best case scenario. I have everything I need. I am fully satisfied in life. I easily celebrate the success of others. I have no enemies. I am honest. I go with the flow. I trust I will always be okay. I am unique and gifted. I am talented. I am inspired and inspiring. I am a success. My life is a success. I see only opportunities. My life has extraordinary meaning. My future is positive and bright. Everything is working out for my benefit. 5 more, 6 more. I am brilliant. I have access to genius ideas. I am intelligent. I am at peace in every moment. I am completely loved. I see the goodness in everyone and everything. I see divine love all around. You know what? I thought it was going to be far more cringe going through those, actually. The I am pure, I am innocent, I am wanted and needed. Growing up, like in my era growing up, you would look at these things and say, oh, dude, that's gay as hell to be saying those things. But that's not my, while I might feel the same sentiment that I felt back then, I'm not going to use the term that's gay as hell, which brings it onto a slightly different point, which is my mindset now is, While I don't throw like that term gay around as, you know, meaning to be derogatory, I also feel now, I think I've come to the realization that I can use other words. There's no need for me to use that word. If it hurts someone for absolutely no reason on my end, meaning like I could easily just use a different word and avoid someone else feeling hurt, then I will. So I'm just going to like I want to eradicate that from my vocabulary because it's the way I see it is not necessary. Do I feel like someone should not get upset about that? Yes. I don't think someone should get upset about that, but I have the ability to control whether someone could or couldn't get upset. I have the ability to control that input into someone else's, right? Like that's their demon to deal with. And I have the ability to control whether I provide that demon or not. You see what I'm saying? Probably not. But like for some of these, like I truly believe these. Like I am honest. I am talented. I have no enemies. I'm not fully satisfied in my life. Like I mentioned yesterday, I feel like I'm part failing my wife and family. I expected to be in a different place. I've worked so hard to be in a different place. But there must be pieces that I'm missing. And I'm not fulfilled because I'm not finding those. Anyway, I'm going to think about these a bit more throughout the day. And I think I'll start saying these every day and just see what comes up. But I have another topic that is very, very sensitive topic, but I have very strong views about it. And I want to mention it. I want to kind of share my thoughts on it, whether you listen or not. And then also, I'm pretty sure I finished up the soda versus water intake video where I switched. Instead of consuming water for the day, I consumed soda. Oh my goodness. And I'm really happy with how that came out. So what you're seeing today is the beginning of a true belief in myself and a desire to be much happier and to where, you know, where I get rejected on something or where I don't get the views that I expect from a TikTok. I need to find a way to deal with that so that it's not affecting me in such a negative way. I'm not sure how that is yet, but I think this is really the beginning of the journey of realizing that I have the ability to control this. All right. This topic. Again, I was just on the bike in the gym and every now and again, I glance up at the TVs that are playing. And it was all the different social media CEOs in Congress, and it was a discussion about the policies and protections for children, because there are a number of children that have lost their lives as a result of social media. And let me start by saying, I can't begin to empathize with a parent that's lost their child. I can't begin. Like, I'm saying that as a parent with a child that's been in a newborn that's been in the ICU for the past two and a half weeks now. And there was, for a week, we didn't know if he was going to make it. But he's okay now. But I have learned a new level of empathy that I didn't understand before. And I can't begin to understand this next level of empathy for a parent that's lost their child. I can't. However, when I saw all these parents holding up photos of their child at this Congress meeting, I got this look that the parents were placing blame on that were holding the social media platforms responsible for the deaths of their children. Now, I don't think I'm going to stop this conversation to order a flipping Baconator. What the heck? I got a coupon that I'll show you.
Hi, welcome to Wendy's. Will you be using our mobile app today?
Hi, no, I won't, but I do have a coupon. Please.
What can we order?
Oh, that's good. Hi, I have a coupon for a $2 breakfast sandwich, and I was hoping to get the breakfast Baconator, please.
What sandwich?
The breakfast Baconator.
Okay.
With no sauce, please.
Okay.
And that would be it. Thank you very much. Thanks. Okay, all right, I'll go to the second window. I'll continue this thought in a second. I'm going to stop this so I don't have to blur her. Oh, I guess I'll just blur the face. So blaming the social media platform. And I think about, when I think about my son, I was saying to the nurse yesterday in the hospital, hi, there's the, okay. Yeah, I was saying to the nurse in the hospital how Ruger, he's 2 years old now, almost two, and he's actually really good at using an iPad. He's probably only collectively had in his life about 20 hours of screen time. And that's always... Thank you very much. That's always monitored by us. And when I say screen time, I'm talking about like pressing pause and play on Spotify or next track or something. Or like he knows how to, from the lock screen, he knows how to swipe across. He knows how to open the camera, the flashlight, the torch. Thank you. Can I have some ketchup as well, please? Thanks. And then... Thank you very much. Cheers. And then, like, if I've got my laptop open, he looks at the screen and things that look like buttons, he's trying to press the screen. So, like, he understands what a button looks like. Anyway, my point in that is he can use an iPad, but he should be watched when using an iPad. It's like, if you have a 10-year-old kid, are you going to let them like leave the house and walk down to the high street or to like a downtown area or to the shops or something to go and do their thing? Just unsupervised. Are you going to allow that to happen? I think probably not. So... Why is it acceptable for parents to allow their kids to be on social media completely unsupervised? Like, I feel like that is the responsibility of the parents. I know it's tough, it's hard, but just giving your kid an iPad or letting your kids be on social media unsupervised when they have no idea how to assimilate all the information that's coming at them and deal with, like, hate or, you know, horrible comments or... disgusting content. They don't know how to deal with that. Like, that is part of being a parent. You should be teaching your kid how to deal with that. I can't believe I'm having this conversation while I'm about to eat a Baconator. And I'm not for a second putting myself in the shoes of those parents because I wouldn't begin to empathize with them. But I don't feel like it is the sole responsibility of these social media platforms to decide anything and everything that a child can see online. I think that's the responsibility of the parents. And that would be really hard, like if that happened to, God forbid, if that ever happened to my child. That would be really hard to accept, to know, gosh, this is horrible to say, that as a parent, you failed in one area of life that just so happened to be so bad, so impactful, that it had the result of the child ending their life. Jeez. I think the parents need to be on top of it. I mean, I hope that Shay and I are astute enough that we are on the ball to realize that we should be on top of this stuff. You know, It's like, I'd say most parents would know that social media can be a disgustingly terrible place. So like, let's compare that to a knife. You wouldn't just give your child a knife and let them go and play with a knife, would you? So why would you give them an iPad or a phone or access to social media and just let them free roam? You know, unless your child is being devious and somehow managing to get around the things that you've put in place. Oh no, I guess I don't need to harp on about this. Oh, 1 second.
Hi.
Hello.
Have you seen your uncle
yet? Yeah, I'm just grabbing breakfast and then on my way.
Okay. Call me when you're in there.
Will do. Alright. Love you too. Bye. Oh my gosh, she's still in bed. What a waste of life. I don't feel that way. Ago. Could have done with a drink. One of the other bits I read in this book this morning was about, it wasn't about how to handle rejection. It was more just like an eye-opener of when someone rejects. Like, let's say this new manager that I have been speaking with since December, just how bad he's been with not responding. It's felt like he hasn't made me a priority. Like I'm kind of just, the whole thing has felt more like, oh, this guy gets like pretty decent views. Let's bring him on. And then if he brings us deals, cool, but we're not actually going to do much for him. And that became very apparent very quickly. Like the conversation all started off as, don't worry, we'll bring you deals. Battery's going to die. But what I'm saying is, the rejection from that, him not replying, isn't a reflection of me. Maybe there are things I can learn from it that I should improve upon to help that from not happening. But him taking that route is not on me. And I need to learn to accept that. All right, I got it before the battery dies.
I've got a little bit of time while Rugi's asleep. So I thought, I posted the, do you want to watch it? Let's watch it right now. Sorry. Here it is. Okay, this is the, I guess I don't need that open. Exchanging water with soda video that I finished, and I actually posted this morning. But I think this is a horribly viral video. I think it's like, I think this could go really good. Let me show you what I have and then I'll explain why I decided to pull it down. What happens if you switch your daily water intake with soda? I started the morning off with a refreshing dose of sugar, and the first few sips, extra tasty. Immediately after that, I felt serious guilt as I took my son to the dentist with a bottle of soda in hand. Now, I've always been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. After the first serving, I made the mistake of reading through the ingredients and realized that just one serving had more than my daily allowance of sugar, 39 grams, and I had to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an even bigger mistake of weighing out how much sugar I'd have to consume for this challenge, which came out to 292.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for a little bit, lots of energy, and now I just feel awful. Only another 55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving, that's 210 grams of sugar. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside? Like, how do I make it better? I have been crazy depressed all afternoon, and I've just been like trying to drink water. I need to run again, try and use up some of the sugar, I guess. And it was awful. I shouldn't have done it.
Okay. And then the retention graph. I'll record my screen. Okay. So retention graph, let's go into view the details. We have a pretty good hook, by the way. At 3 seconds, we're at 73%.
Guilt as I took my son. Started the morning off with a refreshing dose. I'm curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out.
That's a big drop off for explaining the reason for the video.
I'm curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, guilt as I took my son to the dentist with a bottle of soda in hand. Now, I've always been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day?
I'm trying to work out why is that a big drop off?
Of sugar, and the first few sips,
55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving,
that's 210 grams of sugar.
Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place. 2.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for
10 grams of sugar.
Physically and
to go.
And by the fifth serving,
that's 210 grams of sugar.
Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible.
So if you look here from about here on, it's a pretty flat ending. I would say there's a big drop like from this point down to here. Fairly flat here. But this drop, I wonder if by changing the hook, so I just recorded a different hook. We'll see it in a second. Will be even more impactful. I think it's a pretty good hook as well, in addition to this one. Why are these dips so high?
This challenge, which came out to 292.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I
felt out to 292.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for a little bit, lots of energy, and now I just feel awful. Only another 55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving,
that's two. So expressing my progress so far, saying that I feel awful, and if someone feels bad, psychologically speaking, wouldn't you want to see how much worse they get if they're only like halfway through? Anyway, my thought here is I'm going to edit this with sound effects and music and just change the intro to something I recorded just before this and see if we have any difference. I hope we do, and I wonder if I wonder if the video is just that much more entertaining with the audio track behind it. And I'm being selfish thinking that I don't want it there because it's less real. As if I've been going this direction of... I've been going this direction of wanting to make it like super natural, super authentic, as I said, I wouldn't say the other day, super raw, and to feel as if it's just like a random guy who's picked up something to try. But perhaps, like, perhaps I don't have the skills for that yet. So if I think about iterations of what I've changed, I slowed down my pacing a bit more and made it less, used less serious wording. And that worked well for that second Panasonic video. I did not include any audio in, I think, that video or the one before it or the one after it. And it did, you know, we started to see a drop in views without the, like, the audio. By audio, I mean sound effects. Sorry. Okay, so here is our original timeline. And I'm just gonna give it a straight duplicate. Duplicate project as. Yeah, sure, clip vertical 2, that'll do. Or 1, you know what I mean. And then I'm going to go into a previous project and get the audio. Oh, shoot. That's okay, I guess. Go back, put it under... I am on the right project, aren't I? Before I do that, I'm going to bring in the piece of footage I just copied over. Here... God, now you have to listen to my takes. I think the last one was good.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
Okay. That was my best one. I remember that now.
I'm forcing myself sugar into.
Can't be having these pauses, can we, Oliver, on TikTok? It does not work. 316.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8.
I need to give itself a frame before.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
I started the morning.
Wait, that needs to go up a little bit. Damn it, I should have done them together. And then...
...of sugar in 24 hours.
Oh, wait. Hold up. Okay, let's put the audio in there. And then this... which is going to copy, take out of there, and put it here. And instead of the fast version... I'm going to put in this... version and then turn this in sound off. See how this looks.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
I started the morning off with a.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar.
What the heck? What is going on with you there? There we go.
8 times the daily limit of sugar. I'm forcing myself to drink.
So I think that should come in earlier.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
I started the morning off with a refreshing dose.
Okay. I have no idea what this is.
In 24 hours.
I started the morning off with a I started the morning off with a refreshing dose of sugar, and the first few sips, extra tasty. Immediately after that, extra.
I feel like I haven't done this audio editing in so long. It seems odd, but it also seems to be coming back quite quickly.
And the first few sips, extra tasty. Immediately after that, I felt serious guilt as I took my son to the dentist with a bottle of soda in hand. Now, I've always been...
So, I'm not sure with what I'm thinking might happen next, so...
How do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. With a bottle of soda. Now, I've always been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. After the first serving, I made the mistake.
Ooh, yeah, Oliver. Let's get some of this. Oh, I've forgotten how to... Is it this? And then, how do I keyframe it? That's right. So sorry. This, what I'm adding in here, I don't know technically what goes on behind it, but I'll show you before and after, rather than just explain it. So,
after the first serving, I made the mistake.
Normal. And here is.
Of reading through the ingredients and.
Right, so it feels like it's in another room or like really in the background. It's very subtle. I quite like that.
After the first serving, I made the mistake of reading through the ingredients and realized that just one serving had more than my daily allowance of sugar.
39 grams.
And I had to drink 7.5 servings. I think that's over 8 times the.
See here.
Now, how sugar?
39 grams.
And I had to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an even.
So what if? This then, okay. You know, I guess most of this is a bit of trial and error. It didn't used to be trial and error for me. I used to know exactly when to turn this up and down.
And I had to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an even bigger mistake of weighing out how much sugar I'd have to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an...
See, that I think is too far after the fact, so I wonder in here.
And I had to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an even bigger mistake of weighing out how much sugar I'd have to consume for this challenge, which came out to 292.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for a little bit, lots of energy, and now I just feel awful. Only another 55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving, that's 200.
Let me see here.
To go.
And by the fifth serving, that's 210 grams of sugar, physically and
okay.
Daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for a little bit.
Daily intake.
So then, I think it drops down here. I think we have like an impact sound. Let's try something. Sound effects. I like using different tabs. I don't know. That's the same for you. Impact, there we go. Short. Let's stick you in there, you old bastard. Just there.
Recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in. I felt really good for a little bit. Lots of energy, and now I just feel awful. Only another 55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving, that's 210 grams of sugar. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place.
Hell, that sounds... I can't believe I ever would have moved away from this. That sounds so good. Just... The drop, the build-up, like, on that, I'm talking about how what I've said just happens, like, coincidentally to link up with the gap in here of it building up, then the drop in sound, you're like, oh, okay, what's happening here? And then finishes, the boom is on how much sugar is there. Sorry, then my reaction. Wow. Let's see.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours. I started the morning off with a refreshing dose of sugar, and the first few sips, extra tasty. Immediately after that, I felt serious guilt as I took my son to the dentist with a bottle of soda. Now, I've always been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, soda.
So then I think I'll drop this down, but I need to test out how it's going to look going into the next piece, because that is dropped low. Let's just bring this down to here. I don't like... Well, I mean, it makes sense because it's different clips. But you have to open up this from this menu bar once you're on the right clip. Otherwise, you're editing this from, like, this shot, for example.
I've been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. After the first serving, I made feel throughout the day.
I'm gonna see what this feels like. Get me away, you bastard. I thought I hit the top. So you got it building up, and then it shuts down again.
With a bottle of soda. Now, I've always been curious how people who only drink soda, no water, how do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. After the first serving, I made the mistake of reading through the ingredients and realized that just one serving had more than my daily allowance of sugar. 39 grams. And I had to... I had to drink 7.5 servings. I then made an even bigger mistake of weighing out how much sugar I'd have to consume for this challenge, which came out to 292.5 grams. That's over 8 times the recommended daily intake.
I'm about 35 ounces in.
Señor, uno segundo, por favor. Sorry, I forgot to switch the video over to private. So I had to go and do that.
No water. How do they feel throughout the day? To find out, I had to drink 90 fluid ounces of soda. After the first serving,
and now I just feel awful. Only another 55 ounces to go.
And by the fifth serving, that's 210 grams of sugar. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside? Like, how do I make...
I had this thought earlier of, like, do I need to have the message in there? That's part of that tail off, isn't it?
Feel bad for me.
I try to look at life.
Oh my goodness, I've had this in the wrong spot the whole time.
I've been crazy.
Okay, so let's get you over there for the moment.
All afternoon, and I've just been, like, trying to drink. Crazy.
For me.
I've been crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside? Like, how do I make it better? And I've just been, like, trying to drink water. I need to run again. Try and use up some of the sugar, I guess. I was in a horrible place.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I've been crazy depressed. That's 210 grams of sugar. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I've been crazy. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible...
This. Alright, let's see what this looks like. See what it looky looky thoundy thoundy.
I have been crazy depressed all up.
It's quite a long time for that to go down.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I have been crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside?
Oh, feel bad for me.
I have been crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look in crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life.
I guess we're doing zoomed in.
I have been crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside? Like, how do I make it better? And I've just been like trying to drink water. I need to run again, try and use up some of the sugar, I guess. And it was awful. I shouldn't have done it. I'm 40 ounces to go. And it was awful. Physically and mentally, I was in a horrible place.
Oh, feel bad for me.
I have been crazy depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside?
I'm going to correct this Lumakia so it's not on my trousers. So it doesn't look as bad. Oh, that's the wrong spot. Here. So I'm just reducing the mix. I use... pointing at my bloody screen. In here.
Depressed all afternoon. I try to look at life. You know, if something goes wrong, okay, cool. What's the upside? Like, how do I make it better? And I've just...
I guess now I should make this clip bigger.
How do I make it better? And I've just been, like, trying to drink water. I need to run again, try and use up some of the sugar, I guess. And it was awful. I shouldn't have done it.
Okay.
I'm forcing myself to drink 8 times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
I'm just going to bring this up a bit.
Times the daily limit of sugar in 24 hours.
I started the... Okay. Let's export you. I'll stop there. I'm not... Should I do captions? Yeah, screw it. Let's do captions. Yeah, so I'm going to add captions now. And then post it. So, yeah, if you want to go and watch it, go check it out on TikTok. Please. All right. I'm going to do some more research on people that I should be connecting with. So that's what I'm going to do next, and then... I'll record again later because I'm going to go up and see Kobe again a bit later. See you soon. Yeah, it's a Saturday night in the hospital type of vibes. I've got my AirPods in because I've really been enjoyed listening to music in the car on the way home. Or just driving at the moment. It's like a nice bit of happiness. But it's because the 2016 Chevy Malibu... It has like stop-start and it kills the Bluetooth each time, so then it has to take time to reconnect. And so if I'm listening to music, it just... rubbish. But I also realized that these... these videos have probably been... Like when I look at... Like when I was working, I didn't enjoy my work, but I was just making videos because I enjoyed making the video. There was no pressure for income because I wasn't using that income for anything. It was just kind of like putting it all to one side. But since there's become the pressure of having to make money with that, it's changed the whole dynamic for me, and I'm constantly monitoring to see like how much am I making? Am I making enough? Which I know is the wrong mentality.
Oh, noise cancellation. Yeah, I know that's the wrong mentality, but I know I can also see the effect it has on me. Like that pressure, and all that pressure is what I'm just putting on myself. Gosh, this guy driving. He's got no idea what he's doing. Come back, my dude. Funny thing is, he's already hit one of the signs in here that says clearance 6 foot. That's not 6'10". That is not 6'10", because that would make me about 6'4". Doesn't make any sense, does it? That's not right. No, that's not right. What I mean is, where do I think happiness is? I think happiness is what we have going on right now in our lives. Well, not right now, but happiness for us is we don't want, how am I trying to say this? I don't want like a million followers. I don't want stupid goals like that. I have all the things that we need in life, but it's the knowing where the income is coming from. That really is the hardest part. Once that is in a solid place, I feel like I do so much work to get things in place and like analyzing and trying to improve, but they don't seem to be fully in place yet. Like we keep having these setbacks as I went through yesterday. I saw this Danny Duncan interview the other day, and it was a podcast, and he was saying, yeah, if you put in enough time and keep going with it, eventually things will come back around and do right by you. I don't know how much I believe that. I think you have to constantly tweak it and learn it. But I posted the second edit today. Analytics did even worse than the first one. The first one's at just over 10K now. But that one surprised me a lot. And so I was thinking about, how do I deal with those ups and downs? Like, this is going to sound very arrogant, but I've put myself in a place where I'm now expecting like a million views or something in each of the videos. And if it doesn't get close to that, I feel like I failed. And so I need to get out of this mindset that every one of my videos should hit that and just get back into hitting my stride and enjoy making the video. So make the video. I think once Kobe comes home, I'll put myself in a place of doing like a video a day bar weekends. I really just force myself to get back into it, get into the flow. And get into, instead of trying to make things perfect, just making the video for the enjoyment of it and then posting it and doing the same again the next day. Like, just get back into it, you know, and start having fun with it. Okay, looking forward to reading chapter 2 tomorrow morning, and I'll let you know what I find. I'll use a highlighter and take notes this time, then we can talk about specific things. Okay, cool transition. Good night. Into darkness.